What's going on, everyone? Welcome to Box Attack. I'm Dom, and today we are getting into a very, very massive New York Comic-Con haul. All the things that I picked up from the con, including the pops and everything else, and, grab some popcorn. Okay, so there's no real easy way to do this. I'm just going to show you all the stuff I got. We'll kind of go through as quickly as possible, but first up, we have the Into the Spider-Verse Fig Pin set from the Fig Pin booth at New York Comic Con. This set is absolutely awesome. It's got the silver metal behind it, like a silver chrome, you know, kind of metal to it. It looks really cool though. So this set of five was $100, and it came with this cool Fig Pin logo that's colored like the Spider-Man colors, red and blue. And I also have one that's for the Yankees and one that is for the Mets. And so you get these based on, when you pick up something at the Fig Pin booth, you can get a different color Fig Pin logo. Now I did also, I got Tenya. This was from the Fugitive Toys Party. And if you haven't seen that video, I'll link it below in the description. Now, the reason why I like collecting these so much, not only, they look cool, like they're really well designed and they're figures and they stand up. You can leave them in the box, you can take them out of the box, but the Fig Pin app is stupid awesome. So you can like actually unlock the Fig Pins. There's a code on the back of each Fig Pin. You can unlock in the app, you gain points. You can use those points to redeem for different things at a later time. Anyway, I'm getting off track here. The next thing I got is a Glittery All Might from the Funimation booth. This has the 2019 premiere exclusive on it. It's pretty cool. Fig Pin XL, as you can see right there. And then we have a few other My Hero Fig Pins. And these were from various booths here. We have one, this one from the Fig Pin booth. I believe this one was from Toink. And this Midnight here was from Fugitive Toys. And these are all limited actually. So both of these two are one of 1,000 and this is one of 1,500. So these ones are limited. And then I got these other, I got Spider-Man and Captain America here from the New York Comic-Con booth. And these aren't like necessarily limited, but they do have the New York Comic-Con exclusive sticker on the front. And I just thought they were cool. I'm a fan of Marvel. So those were definitely a win for me. Now, since we're on the pin train right now, I will get to the pop soon, don't worry. These pins actually right here, this is a limited set of 1,000 I got from the Loungefly booth. And look at how cool these are. So we have the Infinity Gauntlet and the Nanotech Gauntlet, and then we have I Am Inevitable and I Love You 3000. These pins look super cool. Like I said, this is a limited set from Loungefly. One of 1,000 right here. Avengers Endgame, obviously. I did get this from the Toink booth, and this is a giant magnet pin, I guess. It's the gauntlet, but it holds on with magnets. It's really huge, as you can see. Really cool looking, in my opinion. Let's go ahead and set that off to the side there. I do have a set of New York Comic-Con pins that I picked up. I also have some Tiny Ghost pins. Look at these cute little guys. They look like pizza, like New Yorkers, like a hot dog guy, pizza guy, and somebody taking orders there. Pretty cool. I don't know, pretty cool stuff. I like that. I did also get this pin from the Toink booth, which has the gauntlet in the middle, and it spins, so you can kind of like play spin the gauntlet on which hero is gonna get snapped, I guess. I don't know if that's the point or not. I got another Iron Man pin. It says I Love You 3000, and it actually glows in the dark around the outside here, the blue part. And then I got a Marvel 80 Years pin. I have another one like this that was from Comic-Con San Diego, and it's black, and this one's silver, so I had to pick that up. And then, of course, I am in love with Chomp and Abominable Toys, and be sure to check them out if you're not familiar with them. I got these three limited pins from the Plastic Empire booth at New York Comic Con. So I think that wraps it up for the pin stuff. Let's get on to some of the collectibles. Oh, real quick, before I forget, I did also get this cool backpack. Look at this. Look at this thing. It's got gauntlets all over it. This is a Loungefly bag, and it has Marvel Avengers Endgame at the bottom. This is from Loungefly, and this actually came with the Tony Stark, the gauntlet pop from New York Comic Con. It was a bundle. I had to buy it as a bundle because it sold out at the Funko booth, but this backpack is inevitable. This thing is so freaking cool. So if you see my Fugitive Toys video, you know that I won a prototype. And here is said prototype. This is a mystery mini for the Hobgoblin. And he's flying around on his little thing. But this is pretty cool. I mean, nothing special happening there, but it's a pretty cool prototype to have. I do have, well, let me dig all this other stuff out for you. So I mentioned Chomp and Abominable Toys and Plastic Empire just with the pins and stuff. This is Chomp, and this, I have a Chomp right there on the back, the pink one. This is a special edition for New York Comic Con. This is the Liberty Chomp, and well, you can clearly see why. It looks like the Statue of Liberty. It actually looks pretty cool in my opinion, and I had it signed by the two creators of Chomp. And wow, that smells plasticky. And he even did a little doodle on the side here. So I think that this guy is pretty freaking rad, the Liberty Chomp. And then we have one more. This one is awesome because it glows in the dark. And like I said, if you're not familiar with Abominable Toys, I definitely recommend you give them a look. They make some of these cute little collectible vinyl figures. And this guy glows in the dark, pretty awesome. Kind of looks like a skeleton, as you can see. He's got a little heart on there, so. Super cute little figure. So these are Chomp, and this one just doesn't want to stand up for some reason. Kind of wobbly. Okay, there we go. So Chomp. Next up, we have Tiny Ghost, and they had quite a few exclusives at the New York Comic Con for Tiny Ghost. This one, this orange one, came from Fugitive Toys. And yes, it's just plain orange, like there's really not a whole lot going on with him, but it does glow in the dark and it does look pretty freaking cool, so plus one for that. And we have one of my favorites, this guy right here. This one just looks rad. It's the Muertos Tiny Ghost. Check that guy out. Look at him, he looks so cool. Got a lot of cool artwork going on here, and it was signed by the creator, Reese O'Brien. So he makes Tiny Ghost. He's responsible for all this stuff and responsible for all this amazing artwork on the Tiny Ghost. And I have Tiny Ghosts back here. You guys have seen them before. I've covered them before on the channel. But these are the Tiny Ghost pickups. And I think we're ready to move on to the pops. All right, so we will save the best for last as far as the pops go. But first up, a couple of Marvel pops here. We have Miss Marvel, and she looks pretty freaking cool. These are part of the Marvel 80 Years series. And we also do have Dark Phoenix right here. Now, this was a pop and tea combo. And in my opinion, total missed opportunity for glow in the dark because it just looks so freaking cool. It would look really rad as a glow in the dark pop. But we have Dark Phoenix. I'm just pulling these out of a tub right here, basically. So next up, we do have Evil Groundskeeper Willie and Vampire Mr. Burns. I would have to say out of these two, my favorite is probably Evil Groundskeeper Willie. I grew up on The Simpsons. I love these pops so much. I'm glad they're doing the Treehouse of Horror stuff, a whole series based on it. So we have these two exclusives from New York Comic Con right here. And next up, we have Huntress. I can't even speak right now. This is DC Superheroes, obviously. It's just a kind of a throwback comic pop right here, and I like it when they do these kind of things. And well, the next one here is Dwight, and he's holding his little bobblehead. I know that might be hard to see. Unfortunately, the little bobblehead is not an actual bobblehead. Like, super, super missed opportunity there. Like, come on. What are you guys doing? Like, make it an actual bobblehead. I feel like that would be an important thing. All right, so next up we have Polly the Pigeon, and these two are actually part of the Icons line. If you saw my Funko video from a few days ago, you know why. It's because Funko created this mascot for New York Comic Con, so it wasn't technically an ad icon. It's just an icon, but Polly the Pigeon, there are three variants. I wasn't able to get my hands on the third one because it was at the merch booth and I just didn't have time. All right, so next up we have a couple more Marvel 80 Years pops. We have Captain Marvel and Nick Fury, OG Nick Fury. Both of these are freaking cool. I love this Marvel 80 Years line because, like, I look at the back, they have like the comics on them, and you can see Sergeant Nick Fury and Captain Marvel right there, and just the boxes look really cool. And of course, New York Comic Con sticker, gotta love that. So these two are definitely a win as far as the comic pop collector in me goes, but like I said, we got a lot more to look at. So if you are a fan of anime, then you definitely probably wanted to pick up Dobby and Stain. These are My Hero Academia pops, and they just look freaking pretty rad. Like, I mean, obviously I know that these are shared, and you can get them. I think, Dobby was shared with, Hot Topic and Stain was shared with GameStop, I believe. And they both look really cool. Like, obviously, and you can see here that they're part of this wave, not the newest one, because they have these other characters on the back. But I think that both of these were awesome pickups. I'm going to try to speed along through things here because I don't want to take up too much of your time. But let's move on. Next up here, we got a little Disney, got a little bit of Funko. I have Officer Freddy right here, and he's holding a little coffee cup, has an F on it. And actually, my friend Loco Duck actually made this drawing. He has a booth at like pretty much all the cons. And so he does these rad drawings like this. I will link his Instagram below if you wanna check out more artwork from him. But he gave this to me at the con. And so I put it in the stack with Officer Freddy because it was definitely fitting. And of course, I have Donald Duck here as well, because who doesn't like Donald Duck? He is just super awesome, and I just couldn't resist it. Next up, we have another My Hero Academia pop, and this is the Chrome All Might, Silver Chrome, and we have the Funimation exclusive premiere sticker on the front of here, and this sweet, sweet black box. Like, wow, they've outdone themselves with this black box. It's nice to see Tenya hanging out here. I have Tenya over there on the thing, but I think that this box is absolute fire. This pop is pretty cool. I'm super happy to have picked this up. Another black box pop that I'm happy about is this guy. So this is the Darth Vader Funko collaborating with Futura. It's kind of an artist take on the whole thing. It's got a pretty cool look to it, though. I know it's kind of hard to see through the stack and all the stickers and stuff like that. If you want to see a full video on this and the Boba Fett from this lineup, which I happen to maybe have in the other room, definitely leave the video a thumbs up or leave a comment below. But I picked this up. It was at the Entertainment Earth booth at New York Comic Con 2019. It's a Target debut. The silly thing is here, if you get this, don't pay resale on this. Don't go on eBay and pick one of these up, because the premiere sticker is on the outside. See how this stack is wrapped in plastic, right? The sticker is on the plastic that wraps the stack. So if you take the plastic wrap, this, the trash that you would normally throw away, if you take that off the stack to see more clearly through the pop or through the thing, then you're gonna lose a sticker unless you take the sticker off and put it on the thing. But then it's not how it was from the con. And that's because they put on the stickers at the con. So they just slapped it onto the plastic wrap. And yeah. All right, so we only have a couple more pops left outside of these two. First one here, Stan Lee as an astronaut from Guardians of the Galaxy 2. This one was a must-have, no questions about it. I have him in a stack as well because I'm just kind of a monster like that. Even if it's not worth a lot of money, I still put it in a stack because it's a prized possession to me, like this one is. Iron Man with the nanotech gauntlet. And this is just an amazing pop. I am so happy to get this. Like I said, I got this from the Loungefly booth in a bundle with the backpack or the pin set. I can't remember. One of those came with the pop that I picked up anyway. And I am just super happy to have this because I am a huge Marvel Avengers fan, and B, I needed that con sticker. So I'm super happy that I have this here. This will always forever be a part of my collection, and a couple others that I wanna show you. All right, so next up we do have a Freddy Funko vinyl that was a collaboration with Ron English. This is the Toy Tokyo exclusive 1,000 pieces, and look at how freaking cool that looks. He's got his skull, like he's got his face cut off on like part of it, and you can see like the little Freddy Funko skeleton shining through there. This is a really cool piece. I am super happy to have this. You can see on the back it says Ron English, and it's Freddy Funko. He's wearing a black t-shirt with a red skull or cross skull and crossbones on it, and he's just got his little skull poking through there. Like, I don't know. I think that this is a really cool piece to have. I'm super happy about it, and the box just looks awesome. Like, look at the smiley faces, and it's just really, really well designed. One of these dropped on Funko Shop, slightly different variation, still Ron English theme, still 1,000 piece. It was really hard to get actually online. I didn't actually get one, but I have this one, so I am super happy for that. But we have a couple of very special things to me anyway. This guy right here. So this is Mickey on the Matterhorn bobsled at Disneyland, and this is a 1,500 piece limited edition exclusive. You can see Mickey hanging on for dear life at the front of the bobsled there. I am super, super thrilled to have this. Y'all know I'm big about the Mickey Pops. I have some of my Mickey Grails up there. I am super huge about the Mickey Pops. Super, super happy to have this one as a part of my collection. And I love it so much. So I can't say enough good things about the Mickey on the Matterhorn bobsled. And I'm super happy about this. This is the 1500 piece pink chrome Batman. Yes, you heard it right. It is hot pink. That is a super, super duper pink color right there. And I just think that looks totally rad. I don't know. A lot of people were dissing on the chrome stuff. A lot of people were dissing on the pink color. I think that this is a win all around, especially how it pops on this black box. So we got black, gold, and pink. Super hot color combination, in my opinion. I think that this is awesome. I'm super happy to have this. And I mean, that pretty much wraps up the haul here. Everything else you guys have seen in previous videos that I've showed off. But I wanna know which things that I picked up are your favorite. Drop a comment below. Thank you all so much for watching all the New York Comic Con coverage that I put out. I know there was been a lot, like one every day basically. So I really appreciate all the support there. And if you enjoyed this video, leave it a thumbs up. Let me know your favorites in the comments section below. And if you're new around here, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell so you can be notified when cool videos like this drop in the near future. So I appreciate all the support, everyone. Big shout out to everybody over at the Box Attack Army, part of Patreon there, that get pops sent to them out of my collection every month. And maybe at the end of this month, I'll send out some con sticker pops, which I have not shown off yet. So I don't know, just putting that out there. If you want to join the Box Attack Army, link is in the description below. Again, thank you so much for watching. Once again, this has been Box Attack. I'm Dom, and we'll catch you later.